Cells, such as human cells that we are made of, need to divide many times throughout our lifetime to keep our body functioning normally. And during each of these divisions, inevitably some errors will creep up while the genome is being copied. So cells take great care to protect the parts of the genome which are most important to them. They use a kind of a DNA spell checker to try to reverse some of these mistakes. However, even in such cases, some mistakes still remain and we get mutations. So mutations can cause diseases, and one prominent example of a disease they cause is cancer. I always like to say that cancer is a disease of the genes. Now, that doesn't necessarily mean that cancer is inheritable. It is true that some tumors are inherited, but we think most of them are not. In our lab, we look at the genetic sequences of tumors on the one hand and of healthy cells on the other hand. And by comparing those, we get some insight into where mutations happened that caused the cancer. We are very interested in the mechanisms the cells use to protect themselves from the mutations. We are interested in the places in the genome which are most affected by the mutations, when the mutations happen during the development of the tumor, and why they happen, what causes them. I'm fascinated with the amount of information about how cells function that we can learn from looking at the genomes. So the availability of genomic data has the potential to vastly advance our understanding of biology and also of medicine. By moving from information to knowledge, to our understanding of the mechanisms of human cells, we hope to be able to make the medicine of the future make better decisions about how people should be treated and thereby improving their health. For me, doing scientific research is a bit like solving a Rubik's Cube. It's a quite complicated puzzle and it requires many steps to solve it. And to a person looking from the outside, it looks as if nothing is happening during the time that a cube is being solved. It's just colors shuffling about, and all of a sudden they will pop into place and the cube gets solved. However, what appears like instantaneous discovery is really lots of focused, hard effort, and this is what I think science is. There are years of work which then result in a wonderful discovery. It is quite challenging, but for me it is also a lot of fun.